So now let's do an example. Example transformation. And we start again with our, or we're using again our low pass filter we used in the demonstration of the cutoff frequency in analog and digital domain. And then we can compare this with our impulse invariance method. And so the bilinear transform is a very, very simple recipe. So we just substitute the S with 1 minus Z2 minus 1 divided by 1 plus Z2 minus 1 multiplied by 2 divided by T. So the T was our sampling interval. So with that we are then getting our H of Z, and that's then omega C and omega C plus 2 divided by T, and then 1 minus Z2 minus 1 divided by 1 plus Z2 minus 1. Makes this a bit longer here. And this is now essentially our Z-transformed digital filter. Obviously, so what we need to do now is just reshuffling these sets here, that we can turn this into a data flow diagram here. So next step is now reshuffle the Z2 minus 1 to turn this into FIR and IIR coefficients. So obviously the main headache here is this fraction here, so we need to pull this here out and move it up so that we are getting rid of this double fraction here. So let's write this H of Z here again on this sheet of paper here. So we've got our omega C, and then divided by omega C plus 2 divided by T, and then 1 minus Z2 minus 1, 1 plus Z2 minus 1, like that. So now what I do is I just pull this here out so that we have here omega C, and then 1 over T multiplied by 1 plus Z2 minus 1. So I've taken this here out. So then obviously I need to put this now in here. So 1 plus Z2 minus 1 here. T omega C. And then plus here, and then the rest just stays here. So that's then 1 minus Z2 minus 1. And then the factor 2 stays here. So we have sorted that. So now obviously I can just move that upwards here. So then we have here omega C T, and then we multiply this here with 1 plus Z2 minus 1, and now we have here 1 plus Z2 minus 1 T omega C plus 1 minus Z2 minus 1 multiplied by 2. Quite odd terms coming out of that. So interesting are these products of T omega C, because we know this is basically the mapping back to the sample domain as a factor here. And so now we just need to multiply this here out further. So then we have here omega C T plus omega C T Z to minus one, and then here down here we have here this is T omega C plus Z to minus one T omega C plus and then two minus two Z to minus one. Hopefully I haven't done any mistake here. And so then we can reshuffle this here a bit. Hopefully I managed to squeeze this on this side here, that we have it on the same paper. Omega C T Z to minus one. There's no change here. So now we just need to sort this here by powers of Z and minus. And Z to minus one and no Z to minus one. So we have here we've got the omega C plus two here. So this is here T omega C plus two. And then here we have got plus Z to minus one. And then in brackets here T omega C and then a minus two. And this looks already quite a nice filter which can be implemented nearly. The only annoying thing just now is that this is not one here. So we need to pull this here out, that we have a one plus term here. That's the last step. So we have here then H of Z, so that's omega C T plus omega C T Z to minus one. And then here we've got here T omega C plus two plus Z to minus one, and then T omega C minus two. So what we would like to have here is essentially turn to one, so that we have here omega C T plus omega C T Z to minus one, and we just pull this here out, so that we have here T omega C plus two, and then this is here then one plus Z to minus one, and then here we've got T omega C minus two divided by T omega C plus two. So now what I can do is I can just pull this term here up upstairs. Then we have here something like omega C T divided by T omega C plus two plus, and then here omega C T divided by omega C T plus two. And then this Z to minus one. And then we divide this by one plus Z to minus one. And then this is here T omega C minus two divided by T omega C plus two. So that's now our IIR filter. IIR low pass after bilinear transform.